Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Margaret Clairvaux Catholic Community as we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter. Today's Mass is offered for the people of the parish and all who are following us on the internet. Now, as we prepare our hearts and minds for the celebration of Holy Mass, let us offer a few moments of silent prayer. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. All to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope. But do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of Christ, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Very poor, but very hospitable farmer and his wife. Sunday month, next morning,
the angels found the farmer and his wife in tears.
Their only cow, whose milk had been their sole income, lay dead in the field. The younger angel was infuriated and asked the older angel, "How could you have let this happen?"
"The first man had everything," the older angel said.
Yet he helped him.
He accused the second.
"The second family had little, but was willing to share everything,
and you let the cow die."
"Things aren't always what they seem," the older angel replied.
"When we stayed in the basement of the mansion, I noticed there was gold stored in that hole in the wall. Since the owner was so obsessed with greed and unwilling to share his good fortune, I sealed the wall so he wouldn't find it.
Then last night, as we slept in the farmer's bed, the angel of death came for the farmer's wife. But I gave him the cow instead."
Things aren't always worth the same.
In today's gospel, we hear Jesus giving his farewell speech to his disciples.
And you have to think of the disciples, they're going, "Not again, how can he leave us? We've been with him for 3 years. He was put to death. We were alone again and afraid. And then he resurrected. And now he's telling us he's going to leave." And Jesus says, "I'm not going to leave you orphans. I'm going to send you an advocate, the Spirit of Truth, the Holy Spirit." It's that Spirit that Christ sends us that we receive in baptism, that stays with us for all our lives. It is that Spirit that consoles us, comforts us in times of trouble, in times of sadness. It's that Spirit that inspires us to speak of Christ to everyone else. It's that Spirit that also inspires us to be good examples for people to follow, so that they can see that Jesus lives in us. As he told his disciples, "I live in you and you live in me." We're together. He's never left us. And now, we are his disciples here on earth. He chose us to be his disciples, to spread the word, the good news to everyone, everywhere, that there is hope, but that there is love, and that God loves us. We are the vessel that he uses. He lives through us. Saint Teresa of Avila has this quote: "Christ has no body now but yours. No hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes with which he looks compassion on this world. Yours are the feet with which he walks to do good. Yours are the hands with which he blesses all the world. Yours are the hands, yours are the feet, yours are the eyes. You are his body. Christ has nobody now on earth but yours." We've been called to carry out the message that he gave to his disciples so long ago, but that it is still relevant this day and in this moment. Those are beautiful words that St. Teresa spoke. And it speaks volumes about the love that Christ and the Father has for us. It speaks about the love that we so desperately need at this time, during this pandemic. He reveals himself to us, and that's what he told his disciples. "I love you, and those that keep my commandments
And so he reveals himself to everyone else through us and through these creations that he's created. And he always tells us, as he told his disciples, "And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." How beautiful words from Christ, that if we love him, his Father will love us. And that's what we need. And that's what we need to share with everyone else. That God loves you. And always remind you that you're not God. God is with you. We have hope. Let us open our eyes, and especially our hearts, so that Jesus can reveal himself to us, and we can, in turn, reveal him to everyone else.
Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified on the Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the people of God, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We present before God our Father our petitions.
For Pope Francis, Bishop Edward, Bishop Gregory, all clergy and religious, Holy Spirit grant them grace and wisdom to lead the faithful to a deeper love for Christ and his commandments. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all government officials, that they will courageously uphold the sanctity of human life at all stages, God's definition of marriage, and religious freedom for all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our beloved event, as they prepare to receive the sacraments of initiation, that they may grow in love and faith with assurance of our prevailing support and prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those suffering from coronavirus, for healthcare workers and first responders, for scientists searching for solutions, and for those who have lost their livelihood, may they come to know the loving signs of God and be comforted by his healing presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
for those who have gone before us in faith, including victims of serious illness, that the Lord will bring them home to his Father's house and grant peace and consolation to those who mourn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Patrio omnipotenti, in unità.
grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. This time, all those who are following us through the internet make an act of spiritual communion.
Thank you.
Let us commend ourselves to our Blessed Mother, and we ask her the grace that when we will be able to receive all of you who are following us, we'll be able to receive Holy Communion. Receive it with a great, great devotion and love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restored us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruit of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for announcements.
On April 29th, in accordance with the guidelines of our civil authorities, Bishop Burns issued a decree announcing the process of reopening churches in four phases. We are currently in phase one. Following all directives given by the city and health authorities and by the bishop, we have begun our reopening process. To ensure the safety of Christians, we clean and disinfect the church every morning before opening. Our church is open daily from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Eucharistic adoration is celebrated Monday through Friday from 6 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Confessions are on Saturdays at 4 p.m. or by appointment. The official capacity of our church is 900 people. The maximum allowed, 25% of full capacity, is 225 people. Soon, we will start our ceremonies for the sacraments. Most of our planned ceremonies will have 20 or fewer students at each ceremony, with the restricted presence of 4 immediate family members, including the sponsor. We also need to maintain the standard for social distancing, which is 6 feet. For this reason, we have closed every other pew and marked seating spots in the open pews. Also, please remember to use a mask to keep everyone safe. You can find the schedule of ceremonies of each sacrament on our website. The sacraments of initiation for RCIA will take place next Sunday, May 24th. RCIA in Spanish will be at 9 a.m. RCIA in English at 12 noon. And RCIA for children and youth at 3 p.m. The 9 o'clock and noon masses will be live streamed. Please see the complete calendar of all May and June activities on our website and Facebook page at sbdallas.org and at church entrances. Daily and Sunday masses are still private. Please continue following our masses on our Facebook page and on our YouTube channel. Our parish office will reopen this Tuesday, May 19th. A very special thank you to all of you who are making regular contributions to our church. Please continue giving, either online or by going to our website, www.sbdallas.org, and press Giving, or by mailing your envelope to the church office. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.